Where are you? Karen!
Hi, Matt.
Who are you?
I'm Bullseye.
You know, you act a lot more like Bullseye from the movie than you do in the show, right?
No, I don't.
Oh, yeah, you do.
I'm my own man, Matt.
Enough of that. Where's Karen?
Don't you worry about Karen Page. I got her right where I want her.
You're nothing but a pawn. Do you know what Fisk is doing right now?
Vanessa.
So Daredevil Season 3, is it good? Is it great? How is it? And I have to be completely honest with you guys. After seeing it, I was a little underwhelmed. I mean, I don't know how else to put it other than I just felt a little disappointed. Because I expected much more from the third season of Daredevil. I really enjoy the character. I love the Netflix series. And I just wanted to see a little more. And I thought they were building up. And it felt like they all this build-up really didn't lead to anything. And this season really felt much smaller than the previous two seasons. Now, you expect the first season to be pretty small, right? Matt Murdock pretty much becoming Daredevil. He's not even in the costume until like the very last episode. But in this season, he's never even in the costume, which isn't a real big deal to me personally, because the idea of the hero is the hero, not the costume that he wears. That was something that Frank Miller tried to really hammer into people's heads in his Born Again series. And I thought that that was sort of what they were going for in this season of Daredevil. So him not wearing a costume was not a big problem to me. But what happened was there was just no real climax to this season. It just was a really slow burn. For 13 episodes, it was just slow burn after slow burn. I mean, I don't think the show really got interesting this season until the end of episode 8. By the end of episode 8, I'm like, okay, I'm kind of down for it now. Not to say that the show was bad, because it wasn't bad. It's just a really slow burn. When you look at the previous season of Daredevil, season 2, which I have to say I think is superior than this season, there was a lot of stuff going on. First 4 episodes featured on Daredevil vs. Punisher, plus we have Elektra and Stick and a fight in the Hand, and there just didn't seem to be anything like that in this season. Season 3 of Daredevil mostly focused on the Kingpin and how the Kingpin is slowly manipulating everybody in order to work for him. We really see how smart Wilson Fisk is, where he's taking the FBI agents and basically just using them as pawns, and how he manages to get them to let him out of prison. However, the FBI thinks that they're still in control of Wilson Fisk, but in reality, Wilson Fisk is controlling everything, and he's manipulating everybody through most of this season. And I really like that aspect. I like the fact that Wilson Fisk is playing chess with all these different characters. I like when a villain can do that, and you can see how smart they actually are, and how he's like 3 or 4 steps ahead of Matt Murdock in every turn. But the problem for me is there's not that hook. But when you look at season 2, there was so much going on in that season. We had the introduction of the Punisher, the introduction of Elektra, we had the Hand, we had Styx, we had Karen Page, we had Foggy. We had so much going on with that season that when you look at this season, it just feels like a much slower, smaller season. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing, but I can easily name like 5 great moments in season 2. And in this one, I can name a couple. Like, I think the prison scene was amazing. It was like the hallway scene, but better. I thought it was fantastic. I thought the cinematography in this season was great. But when you really look at the end of all 13 episodes, this was basically just the Kingpin getting out of prison, manipulating everybody, and Matt Murdock coming back from the brink of death to take out the Kingpin again. That was basically it. This could have easily been like an 8-episode story arc, and they stretched this thing to 13 episodes, and that's something that Netflix always messes up on. This story did not have to be 13 episodes. However, the one thing I do think this season did a great job with was the character of Bullseye. I was really worried at how they were going to, you know, take care of this character from the comics. I'm a big Bullseye fan, and in the comics, Bullseye is a psychotic, insane person who is really good at like shooting and doing all kinds of things and always hitting that bullseye, hence the name Bullseye. I was really worried how they were gonna, you know, handle his character in the show, and I have to tell you, I think that was the best part of the season. They handled Bullseye the way Bullseye should have been handled. They took care of his backstory. They stayed pretty true to his backstory. And you really see how this guy started off as what we thought was a sane person and then just going completely insane by the middle toward the end of the show. I mean, I love that idea. I love how they didn't really handicap his abilities. We see him ricochet bullets off of poles. I mean, he's throwing glass and chandeliers and stuff, and he's hitting bullseyes every time. I was really worried that they were going to kind of just nerf his abilities to try to make it more realistic, but they did it, and I liked that, and I enjoyed that. Yes, he was dressed as Daredevil for the majority of the show, which I guess doesn't really bother me too much. I wish it would have just been Bullseye and not Bullseye dressed as Daredevil, but that's the route they went in, and I didn't have a real problem with that. I thought that was a great payoff. I really enjoyed the Bullseye character. Unfortunately, when you look at the rest of this season, it just feels really underwhelming. The one thing I thought they were building up to, they completely botched. They completely botched, and that was the death of Karen Page. Now, full disclosure, I like Karen Page. I didn't want Karen Page to die, but it was clear from the first episode that they were setting this up. If you guys are unfamiliar with the story from the comic books, in Daredevil issue number 5, Guardian Devil, Karen Page is killed by Bullseye. They were setting this up so clearly in this season. They even had the scene going in the right place. Karen Page was in the church. Daredevil was fighting Bullseye, and it looked like Bullseye was going to kill her. They were playing it scene from scene from the comic, but when they panned out, it actually killed the priest and not Karen Page. So it was like a complete bait and switch. It drove me nuts. It was like, you were building this for the entire season. You were building to this moment. This was going to be Matt Murdock's most shameful moment, where he let Karen Page die. He couldn't stop Bullseye, and then you completely botched it. It would have been the only thing memorable about this season, but you had nothing. You completely wasted it on killing the priest, and it makes no sense. You completely took the source material of the comics and just switched it because you didn't want to kill Karen Page. If you didn't want to kill Karen Page, then you should have never even led up to that moment. It felt very Walking Dead, and I didn't like that. Where you have the source material, you're clearly going for the source material, but instead you decide to kill Abraham. It doesn't make no sense. So I know it may sound like I'm hating on Daredevil Season 3, and I hope that's not the case because I really liked Season 3. I just think when you look at all three seasons of Daredevil, I think it's the weakest of the three. Season 2 had so much going for it, but when you look at Season 3, they just didn't have everything they could possibly do. I mean, think about it. Styx was already dead. Elektra is apparently dead again. So a lot of their main draws weren't in this season. The only main draw was Bullseye in the return of Wilson Fisk. So they kind of went in the season with a handicap. But that is my review of Daredevil Season 3. I hope it doesn't feel like I was just sitting there hating on it this whole time, because I actually really did enjoy it. But I'm really curious to know what you guys think. How did you feel about Daredevil Season 3? How does it rank among the three seasons? Be sure to leave your comments in the comment box below. And until next time, as always, I'm Robert Storms, and that's my opinion.